Hello, my name is Justin Hatch, and I'll be showing you just a few basic audio mixing functions in Audacity. First, Audacity is free audio recording and mixing software, easily found and easily downloaded. When you open up Audacity, you should see an interface similar to this. You can see that I added two stereo tracks represented by these blue waveforms here. One is an unedited recording I used for a different tutorial, and the other is an intro that we will play with. I added these by simply dragging them from the desktop and dropping them onto the Audacity interface. Note that each time you drag a clip onto the interface, it will appear on a new track, this larger container here. You can also add tracks by going to Tracks, then Add New, then Stereo Track. With each clip's waveform, a flat line represents silence, and waves are proportional to the volume of the sounds they represent. And as with most audio or video editing software, I can click to place the playhead where I want to begin listening, and pressing the space bar will allow me to play back my audio from that point. You will notice that this audio is really raw, and we would want to do a lot of work to it before publishing it. Hello, hello, hello. Here we go. Hello. My name is Justin Hatch, and today I'd like to show you how to perform just a few basic editing functions in iMovie. Let's try that again. Hello, my name is... Let's start by zooming in to get a better look at our waveform by clicking our zoom tool up here and then clicking on the portion that we want a better look at. With this closer view, let's get rid of that long period of silence that you will have at the beginning of many clips, as well as the throat clearing and false start. To select and edit any portion of the track, you will first want to make sure that you do two things. First, select the selection tool, represented by what appears to be a capital I up here. Second, make sure that you stop the track as opposed to pausing it. Note an idiosyncrasy of Audacity is that stopping, which you will do by hitting the space bar, returns you to where you have last placed your playhead. Typing the letter P will pause the track where it is at, but you will not be able to edit until you stop the track. With that done, we can just click and drag across the unwanted portion and hit your delete key. Note that my intro and voice clips are now set to play simultaneously. To avoid this, I can click my move tool up here, which allows me to move my voice track out past my intro track like this. Many of your word processing commands also work in Audacity. For example, if we wanted both of these on the same track, I could simply highlight the intro below . Press Command C, place my playhead at the beginning of my first clip, and press Command V. I want to keep them separate for now, so I'll just undo that with Command Z. Now let me show you how to split a clip, an extremely useful function. Let's say that I wanted to move pieces of my clip independently. All I need to do is place my playhead where I would like the split, and then I'll hit Command I, or Edit, Clip Boundaries, Split. Now, after clicking the Move tool, I can move my clips freely. To join them back together, I can just go back to the Selection tool, highlight both clips, and hit Command-J. You will also want to know how to apply effects in Audacity. To apply them, you can just highlight a portion of your track, and then select one of the effects from the drop-down menu. Fade in and fade out are popular ones for beginning and ending projects, and I think a nice fade out applied to the intro would work well here. And finally, two good ways of adjusting your audio levels are the gain controls here on your track, as well as use of the envelope tool up here. You can also mute a single track or click solo if you want to hear only that track. I remember that our intro was a little loud, so I will just adjust the gain on the track a few decibels. And the intro to our track now sounds like this. Hello, my name is Justin Hatch, and today I'd like to show you how to perform just a few basic editing functions in iMovie. Audacity is a really robust tool, and there's a lot more that you can do with it, but these few functions should get you started. Thanks for watching. As a reminder, this tutorial was created in the Digital Writing and Research Lab at the University of Texas at Austin. Check us out on Facebook and at dwrl.utexas.edu.